Toon Link versus Mario. You match up Toon Link. Toon Link can kind of stuff Mario out, but Alex isn't allowing that. Well, Kevin's not allowing that. He's going in with his pills. Mario can kind of shut Toon Link down, though, with his combos. He has pretty good combos, and Toon Link is just the right weight for Mario shenanigans. Also, Kevin is very good with his movement. Kevin meaning Thing 1. I don't know why that's the name. Thing 1 and Thing 2. Goddamn self. Give me 1 second, guys. Not like anyone's listening, but you know, in case you are. For all of you wondering why I'm not in this tournament, because I'm too good. So, this is exactly what Toon Link does not want to be behind in this matchup. I feel like that's with anyone, but with Mario, when Mario gets a lead, it's very annoying to try to get from him, because he's a wily bastard. Very good at playing the keep away game, and his combo game is very strong, so if he catches you out, he can pretty much almost, you know, he can tack on at least 50% in one combo. Power deciding that he no longer wants to live, and Kamek being the nice man that he is, less than bad, and then kills himself. What? So, he's gonna not want to approach exactly the opposite of what you're seeing on the screen right now. See that? See what happens when Toon Link approaches? Doing a pretty good job playing the keyboard game, but the only thing about Toon Link, well, one of Toon Link's flaws is that if you catch him out doing the wrong projectile, he's pretty open, and that's what happened right there. Alright, so here we are, round 2. So, Power starting off pretty strong by trying to play the keep away game. Ooh! It's because that happened because he was above the ledge, not under it. So it acted as if he just did a normal there. You'd know that if he was real Toon Link. So, yeah. This is the hard part about this matchup. Trying to get back your lead, but luckily for Toon Link, he has 3 projectiles, so he doesn't really have to commit to anything, unless you're committing to forward smashing, in which you get hurt. So Kendo64 is kind of running away with this. What Power's going to want to do, like I've been saying, he's gonna wanna kind of fall back. He's been playing at the mid-range with Toon Link, which is all fine and dandy when you, you know, you're ahead. He's been playing at mid-range with Toon Link, which is all fine and dandy when you're ahead. But, you know, now what Kim is making him do, Kim being Kim to 64, he's making him have to come into close range where he's still pretty good, but that's not really where he wants to be. I mean, when you have three projectiles, you're not going to want to, you know, get in unless you're about to, you know, put on the damages. So, I can't really say much about what Mario is doing. Mario is just Mario. He jumps around, throws, kills, writes prescriptions, then he kills you. Ooh! He tried to go for the roll behind lead, but Pyro can do it. I don't know, Pyro has not been hitting his recoveries. He hasn't been perfect in the ledge. Ooh, calling out the roll. Are you coming to commentate?
No.
Okay.
I was told by a birdie that the audio is messed up.
The audio is messed up?
Yeah. I'll just wait till...
Have I been talking for nothing?
I think... Is the mic good? Hey, can you guys hear us? Who's in the chat? Let us know. Let us know what's going on.
Okay, Power switching to Roy, being a, I don't know if this
what a
is
sellout, a, bro.
I don't know if this is a better matchup, still. Toon Link was still a good matchup. Mario loses the sword character.
I thought he was going all Toon Link, but,
Alex doesn't do anything he says. Don't believe this.
Everyone's a little bit of a sellout in their heart, you know?
Never does anything he says.
Does Kim have bars? This dude got bars?
Yeah, man. Wait, are y'all going to 167 today?
We were going to after everything's done. Probably kind of late.
I might join you.
Hold off that long?
Yeah.
You know, last time you guys were fiending...
Yeah, well, I just won money, so, you know, I wanted to go ahead and spend
immediate
it.
Immediate splurge.
Yeah. I wanted to spend it before inflation.
Yeah, no, I get it. That makes sense. So Alex has been talking shit about the new 167 pork.
Okay,
I don't
look,
know if you have a stamp
it's not,
on it.
It's not what it used to be, but it's not it's not bad, per se.
He just said it was like they... Like, it was just kind of grinded up.
Well, it's not grinded up. First of all...
Like, minced.
I'm going to say this, and I want everyone in Alabama and the world to hear me. Don't trust Alex's taste or opinions on food.
Why not?
Because Alex is a baby when it comes to food. Alex has the taste buds of a five-year-old.
Damn.
And,
He does love pizza.
He does
That's
love
a pretty,
pizza. He loves pizza. He didn't eat his first hamburger until college. I'm the one who fed it to him.
I don't think I believe that.
You can ask him.
All right.
You can ask him.
That's a little strange, Alex. Come on.
He grew up...
What are you doing?
You asked this man. He grew up on chicken tendies and pizza. That was his life.
That's the American way, dude.
Nothing
wrong with that.
I almost want to report his mom to, like, DHR, but he's too old now. That's not...
It's a little messed up.
But, I mean, he's pretty fit, so I guess it works.
She was a teacher. There was the cafeteria. She was probably just feeding him cafeteria food his whole life. He never really was susceptible to, any other type of
20-year
food.
Cafeteria food. Dear Lord. Yeah, man.
Dude, do you know Koopa from Mobile?
Yeah, he came here last time.
Yeah, he went to 167 with us, and we learned quickly that he had never had rice before.
And how? That
dude,
is the most eaten food in the world.
Yeah, and it was funny because we had someone from Birmingham that was with us, and he has like an East Asian family and everything. He was like, yeah, I've eaten rice every single day for my whole life. And Krupa was like, I don't know, man, I've never had rice before.
It is not only the most eaten cheapest food. It is the cheapest food. How? Is Koopa, is he rich?
No. He's just
not bought. It's
the Alex thing. It's just like chicken tendies, pizza, Sammy's, what have you. That's all he's got, dude. How did that down smash miss? Are you kidding? Are you joshing me? Damn, it's crazy. I know top players, by the way. This guy's beating HBox. Not with this character, though.
He has beaten HBox.
Where's the Yoshi, bro?
With an even worse character. And HBox is playing his main, so.
Were you there on that fateful day?
No. That was a Birmingham
Hall. HBox's face was sick when he lost. He was like, dude, what the fuck?
Yeah, he didn't know what was going on. No, I think I was there.
Maybe.
He didn't know what was going on.
Mario's so aggressive.
He also believed that Kimmel was the best Yoshi he's ever played.
Hey, you know? Can anyone compare?
Yoshi
that is there anyone played? Actually that...
There is actually pretty good Yoshi. Yeah.
Okay.
I don't remember the name because I always think it's Dumb Shiny, but Dumb Shiny doesn't play Yoshi. So.
Who?
Dumb Shiny.
Dumb Shiny? Yeah. Is he dumb?
I don't know.
Is he shiny?
Maybe.
We'll never know.
We'll never know.
I think that move should have knockback.
Puppy?
Yeah. Like, it's weird that they don't go anywhere, you know? I guess that's what Mark was for, but...
This character is just supposed to show you not to play this character.
Yeah.
He's supposed to show you that Mark.
Do people think he's worse than Mark? In general?
Roy? Yeah, he's worse than Mark in general. But,
oh, is he, though?
But, I will say, a good Roy...
A skilled Roy. You know what they say about a skilled Roy?
So fucking... He's very annoying. I don't know if I'd rather play Mark, because a good Mark is also... Well, that's it.
That's it. Okay, so now I'm going to fix the audio, hopefully.
30 and a half.